everyone, welcome to Mr. Tech Dinner again, and today we are going to solve Excel for Business Essentials. So today we are going to practice the week 2 practice quizzes. Some of you already told that my practice in my video I don't mention the practice videos of week 2, so that's why I'm going to show you this again. So first of all, this is the practice video of performing calculation. Okay, so our first quiz is about formulas, how to make formulas and in your spreadsheet. Okay, so first question, calculation has been used in cell A3, which of the following was entered in A3? A3. So what could be the formula? We need to figure out that. Okay, so for this purpose, we need to figure out the formula. Which could be the formula? If we divide A1 by A2, 20 by 5 will be the answer in A3. Yes, that will be. But if we divide A2 by A1, 25 divided by 20, this will be 1 by 4, not 4. Okay, and same goes for 3 and 4. These functions will not get the answer. Okay, so that's the formula. Question number 2, for data shown, which of the following formulas will not give the result 2? Okay, so you need to solve it like the previous one. If we think about the first question, A1 minus A2. Okay, so A1 minus A2, 8 minus 4 equal to 4, 4 divided by 2 equal to 2. Yes, this will be the answer. So you should think that not give the result 2, right? Not give. Okay, so this will give the result 2. This formula will also give the result 2. This will also give, but not this one. This one will not give the result 3 because they already removed the bracket from A1 minus A2. Okay, so this will be answer. What is the result of the simple calculation entered into the formula in the bar Excel? Equal to 7 plus 3 into 4. The result will be 3 into 4 equal to 12 plus 7 equal to 19. Okay, so we're going to our next quiz, which is basically formulas in context. Okay, so formulas in context, first question, business, small business buys a second goods and then resells them at a local market. Which formula typed into C2? Okay, what the formula could be? This is the purchase price, this is the sale price. Okay, so how can we figure out the profit, right? We can minus purchase price from sale price. So we need to do is B2 minus A2. Okay, a customer has spent $3,296.99, but he wished to give them a 5% discount. So how the discount will be count? We need to multiply the cost of good with a discount. So A1 into B2 equal divided by 100. That will be the discounted amount. No, we cannot divide by 100. Okay, just multiply. We should multiply A2 with B2. That will be your answer. Payroll has been calculated. The tax for each employee. First, they must add the base salary to the commission, and then they calculate the tax on the total. Okay, so how should they do it? Okay, so first of all, look at A1 plus A2, base salary plus commission into tax rate. Then the amount we get, there will be tax to pay. Okay, so this is the formulas in context. So what will be our next quiz is actually functions. Okay, functions, there are two types of functions. So first function, select the formula that correctly and efficiently adds all cells from B3 to B6. Okay, so this will be some B3 divided by B6. That will be the range, B3 is to B6. Okay, so that will be your answer. Pressing auto sum, you must type equal. No, because when you press auto sum, this will automatically place enter, so you don't need to place the bar equal. Okay, so Ashin auto sum used auto sum to create the calculation in D2 as shown. Okay, then he used the fill handle to copy it down to D4. Okay, so what calculation will be shown in D4? The calculation will be A4 is to C4. Okay, so this will be same, right? So we are going to our next quiz, which is basically functions 2. Okay, so what the functions do about? First question, the correct way to get an average values in A3 to A9 would be average A3 to A9. Okay, then which using the screenshot below, which function would give you the value 4? We should look at the formulas. Okay, so which first one is sum? No, the sum will not be 4, never ever. And max, mean, average, yes, minimum. A2 is to A5. That means between A2 to A5, the minimum value is 4. This will be your answer. And this is screenshot using, if you're not sure, okay. So what function will be? A2 is to A5. This is the max, right? The answer 9 will be the max one. Okay, so this is the answers. So we are going to our next quiz, which is about absolute cell references. So first one, to change a relative cell reference A1 to an absolute cell reference, you should use A1 then F4 button. That means $A$1. Okay, when you press the F4 button, it's automatically be like that. The keyboard shortcut to create an absolute cell reference is F4 or command D, or in case of Mac, command D, or just F4 in case of Windows. Okay, the calculation shown will give the correct discount for the first item, but when you copy down the formula, down it, don't give the correct answer in the next two terms. Which of the following will address the problem? Okay, so here's the problem. Actually happened that D2 is to A2, retail price into discount price. Okay, so they don't give here the dollar sign. I mean, they don't press the F4 button. Okay, so we need to press F4 D2, then we should press F4. Then it will become dollar sign D, dollar sign 2 into A2. Then the discount rate will gradually attached with the spreadsheet. So that's done. Absolute sale references. So calculation across sheets. This is our next MCQs. In order to use values in other worksheets in a calculation, you must copy them into the worksheet. False. You don't need to copy them. Okay, so the formula equal to sheet one, A2 is to A2 tells Excel to multiply the value in A2, then in sheet one, and then the value in A2 in the current sheet. Okay, so you can work across the both sheets simultaneously. You don't need to wait. When you reference cells on other sheet in a calculation, you can use relative reference to copy down the formula on other cell. Yes, true. That's true. Okay, so we already completed our calculation across sheets. So that's all for this. There are some practice challenges. You can also check this out. There are some ninja techniques, Excel options, and the assessment, final assessment. I already made the video. The video description is already given here. You can check this out. Okay, so till then, stay home, stay safe, and thank you. And don't forget to like and subscribe.